everybody, and welcome back to my channel and the horrible lighting in this room. As you can see, nothing has changed since last time. Yeah, it took me like a week to pick my paint color. So I've picked it and that's finished, but yeah, nothing else has been done. I'm trying to figure out the IKEA build your own furniture thing and it's just taking me a long time. So I'm really sorry if you're looking forward to this room revamp video, but I do think that this is my opportunity to kind of do it right the first time, and I really want to do it right the first time. So it may take a little bit longer than expected, and then hopefully I can also fix the lighting in this room because I just don't have any options at this point, especially because I've packed away basically all of my lamps as well. This is my cat. See her? She comes into my room every morning and she headbutts my door open. So she's just gonna be in this video. She's just gonna chill, honestly. Today's video is going to be something that I've never done before. It's called Styling My Corset Collection for the Summertime. I have a couple corsets here, but I'm going to put on a disclaimer and say that they are not the really fancy, expensive corsets that one would expect. I am still a student struggling with money. So actually a lot of these corsets I've kind of found throughout my time working at Hot Topic, and I've just kind of accumulated them, and I think that they're still really cool and unique in their own ways. And I love wearing corsets, especially for the summertime, because everything is, well, number one, it's hot, so you want to wear something a little bit more scandalous, but at the same time you want to kind of keep your alternative vibe, so corsets are the perfect way to go for that. So I will show you my corset collection, and then I will show you the corset tried on from the styling. So without further ado, let's get on to the first corsets. So the first corset that I have is actually the very first one that I ever bought. It is not your typical corset, so it's not actually ripped by anything, but I still want to show it because I think that, you know, when I first got it, I was so excited to even own a corset, only to find out that it wasn't actually, in fact, a real corset. So I got this one from Hot Topic, and it was when Hot Topic was very heavily selling the brand Royal Bones. If you know the brand, they are so cool. I actually really miss Hot Topic selling that kind of stuff. Dan Goodman, anything by Dan Goodman and Royal Bones and that kind of collection, I used to go crazy for, and that's what I always thought of when I thought of Hot Topic, that like punk, grunge, like just alternative fashion that you couldn't find anywhere else at the time. Unfortunately, that is not the case anymore. So that is why I have not let this go. I bought this when I was in probably late elementary school. I'm now in third year university and I still wear it and it still fits. Oh my god, that's so bad. As you can see, it is not ribbed. It is just kind of like a, it's just a corset styled top. My favorite part are these very cool, like the hooks. I love that look. But this is so cute. I wore this to the Marilyn Manson and Rob Zombie concert. I will show you a picture right here. I got so many compliments on it. This thing, I don't think will ever go out of style in my wardrobe. I think you can just pair it with so many different things because it's so tight. And because it's not ribbed, so it doesn't really hurt you, you can also wear it on top of like fishnet shirts or mesh shirts, and it looks so cool. I love the vibe of this. So let's see how I styled it. We'll be right back. next one that I have is, this one's actually ribbed, boned. Somebody please correct me on that. And this one I also got from Hot Topic. The amazing benefits of working there is that the discount is very good. So when you come across old Halloween stuff from years past, you can just kind of snatch it for a very, very good price. So this is kind of like my witchy corset. That's what I call it. It is just so beautiful. This is the front of it. You may not even be able to see it on camera, and that is absolutely devastating. Are you leaving? Kind of show you up close, maybe. Oh, there it is. It's got this like beautiful like moon and stars print on it. Very like witchy, or very like moon gothic. I love this. It has a cute little frill detailing that goes across the top and the bottom, and then a really interesting like the front, because it has this. It has such a nice shape to it. I just love this on. And then the back is lace up, like a legitimate corset. And there is ribbing through the front and on the sides as well. Let's see how I went ahead and I styled this one. Is isn't exactly a corset either. It's kind of like the first one, but this one is in fact ribbed slash boned. I'm gonna get this wrong the whole video, so just tolerate me, please. The front is in the style of corset. This is the top. So it's ribbed on the back, sides, and front. This red kind of design here is so pretty. I also love that it doesn't just not have anything up here. Like, having this little vest part is wonderful for putting like collared shirts on top or like jackets. Oh, you feel so cool. The back is lace up like a corset, and it zips up in the front like this, and then it has buckles to kind of bring in your waist. This is probably my favorite thing to wear to concerts and a whole bunch of other stuff. This one I also got in Hot Topic. I was probably in high school when I got this one. So quality-wise, this thing is fantastic. But because I've worn it so much, the back, I would say the only disadvantage is you see the back wiring, or boning, ribbing, whatever it's called. It has started to bend a little bit. So that is probably my only thing with this, now that it is kind of starting to, you know, break from wear and whatnot. Let's see how I style this one. next corset that I have is another one from Hot Topic. This one is kind of different though within regards to shape and whatnot. This one's rather interesting. I also got this one for Halloween when they put out like all the Halloween costumes and stuff. It was advertised as like a clown corset, something like that. I love this really cool like stripey design. I think it's really flattering. The different thing about this one is ribbed as well on the sides, front and back, but this one features cups inside as well, which is fantastic because I feel like with corsets you can't really wear bras most of the time, so it's actually nice to have that extra support, especially when the fabric is thin like this. I got this one on a small and it fits so nicely. The only thing about this one that I actually don't like is that one of the sides has this little bow on it, but at the same time it looks like it's being held by like two stitches, so I might just rip it off and wear it as is like that. I mean, just because it's a Halloween costume does not mean that I can't wear it in every day, right? Let's see how I styled it. This one is actually straight up a Halloween costume. Now, this is going back to like when I was in elementary school, when Hot Topic sold like more Justice League merch and Batman merch, and they used to have like those towers full of that kind of stuff. So this one, this corset is from the Batman collection, and it is part of Poison Ivy's costume. So this one is like a bright green corset. This is so cute. I love this color. If you've actually seen my last style video where I style different clothing for Halloween costumes and everyday life, this is actually part of it. This is what I use for my Hex Girls cosplay. This is my favorite thing in the entire world. Now, I don't know what I was thinking because once again, I did get this in elementary school. Looking at all the other corset sizes, they are all small and mediums. Please explain to me why I bought a large and extra large. I don't know why I did that to myself, but obviously it doesn't fit me that great. So unfortunately, I can't just wear this one by itself. I almost always have to put something underneath it, like a layer underneath it, just because it's real loose and I have it pulled to the back. This is the back, as tight as it can possibly go. And then the only other downfall to this isn't like a lace up or a zip up like these other ones. It's like this really stiff like metal thing that you kind of have to like jam in to like get it to work. But those are only like minor things, right? We all suffer for fashion. But yeah, let's see how I style this one.
Don't know where it ends. Then it's back to bed again.
TikTok on the big clock. The very, very last one that I will be showing today is a legitimate corset. So you can now thank me. We are done with the Hot Topic corsets and we will move on to one that is actually boned, ribbed properly, and has a little bit more of a shape to it. This is what I would call a real corset. It is funny though, because I don't have the money to spend on these big corsets. This is actually a part of my prom dress. For anyone wondering, I got my prom dress. I will try to put a picture somewhere here. I purchased my prom dress on the Gothic website Devil's Night UK, and it did ship straight from the UK. I don't know what it's called, but I can put a link in the description if anyone is interested. I know unfortunately proms are getting canceled this year, but you know, for future reference, you never know. I saw this actually doing a Google search for prom dresses when I was in grade 7, and I'd saved it to my phone and went, I will not go to a store to get a prom dress. I want this one, and I will order this one if it's the last thing I do. So when prom rolled around, there were so many people buying all these prom dresses from like online, and they were coming in and they were just horrendous. They were train wrecks. I was like, oh god, I'm so nervous. I gave the store, I did custom measurements, and I also did custom measurements on the skirt length as well. And I came in and, oh my god, you don't even understand how happy I was. Number one, that it even fit. And number two, that it didn't come in looking like a train wreck. I did have to steam the skirt. I had to pay for the skirt to get steamed because it's just like a massive tulle. But if I looked at the prices and like the comparisons, I think I got a pretty good deal for what it was. So the best part about this prom dress though was that the corset and the skirt were two different pieces. Number one, it was easier to get on. And number two, I could actually wear the corset out in everyday life and not have to be restrained to just having it for a prom dress. So you probably saw in the pictures, but I will show you this corset. It is kind of in the style of, I would say a cross between like romantic goth and like a steampunk kind of vibe. But this is the corset front. It has these beautiful buckles right in the middle of the corset here, and they actually do, they are functioning, so they're not just glued on. You can open and close them, and then the top or the middle would open up if you actually open them all up. All of these like beautiful side details with the little chains. I have yet to have a problem with this corset, and I have worn it a couple of times. Where you see all the red lines, that is where it is ribbed, so it is quite a sturdy corset, I will not lie to you. And this is the back of the corset. As you can see, you can lace it up all the way down, and they've left me quite a bit of room with this kind of back flap, but sometimes I just kind of tuck it around the side, like so that you can actually just kind of see like my back. Now, apologize for the try-on haul, this thing takes two people to get into. I haven't yet mastered the art of tying this thing up, so if it looks a little bit loose, I definitely could have gotten it tighter, but you know, it's a lot of work. It's a lot of work that I did not realize. But because this is such an elaborate corset, let's see how I've styled it for everyday wear. Video. Thank you guys so much for checking this channel out and watching. Give a thumbs up if you liked this kind of video. Like I said, the room videos, I'm I mean, I'm just gonna have to kind of add it as I go. Unfortunately, I don't think it'll be up anytime soon now, but I've thought about it and I've definitely set up a line of really fun new videos that I think are a good time. So thank you guys once again for watching, and hopefully I will see you sometime next week on a new video. Thank you guys so much.